Welcome back to Moth Plays Dark Cloud 2. This is Mr. Moth, and we are in the final episode. In this episode, we'll fight the final boss of Dark Cloud 2, the Dark Element Evil Made Flesh, in what is going to be one of the hairiest final battles. I honestly hate this final battle. It's always kind of a... But first we have to get past all this crap. We just steamrolled through these with Steve. Honestly.
Not doing too bad. Not doing too bad.
Incidentally, before I started recording again, I did go ahead and make some fresh cheese and chicken for healing. Not as much as I would have liked on the chicken. I didn't have the parts on hand, the materials on hand for more than a handful, but hopefully it will be enough. Hopefully it will be enough. I almost made as much cheese as I can carry. So, hopefully we have enough healing items for the final, and we do have a couple of resurrection powders, which we're probably going to need. I mean, the final battle is not, well, after all, it is the final battle, so. Unfortunately, it's also a timed final battle. So I can't, be as cautious as I was when I was fighting Griffin. Subtitles all the bosses have in the Dark Cloud games. It's just so cool. They have such a majesty to them. Steve here, because Steve is useless in the final battle. I mean, Steve is completely useless against Dark Element. Dark Element's gimmick, you can either damage him with Max or Monica at any given time. He'll take damage from one, and no cell damage from the other. The Ride Pod can't damage him at all. So, onward and upward, up the dream spiral. Ether? Really?
Wait till they get a load of this! Get lost!
Okay. We're getting closer and closer. And so is that. So long and long and long and long climbing and long climbing. And I believe this is it. Nope. I forgot about these guys. Are you freaking kidding me? Finny frenzy with all this going on?
Wait till they get a load of this! These guys are tough! Let me at them!
That's it. And all that's left to do now . Here we are. See, we got 5 minutes. shit. This is the attack I hate. Oh shit. Oh shit. I've never seen him do it twice in a row before. I'm lucky I didn't get hit by it that time. And there it is. That's it. That's it. I have just beaten Dark Cloud 2.
I never believed a human could be so strong.
Had a lot more time left on the clock than I usually do, too. Now,
you'll all be dead yourselves when the moon falls. You'll find me in hell, waiting for you.
So... here's the moon of destruction, still falling.
It's
so
over.
Now what happens?
It's all over. I can't believe that was inside me. Then again, it was probably me who created it in the first place. At last, it's all over. Alexandra, I remember. I've remembered what I have to do. I know what was passed on to me in my memory. How to stop the Star of Oblivion. One day, there'll be no need for the Star of Oblivion. And I'll be the one who disarms it. The Ancient Ones told my ancestors how to stop the Star of Oblivion. But that memory was locked away. My family has passed down that knowledge from generation to generation.
So hurry up and stop it already!
One day, when humans became worthy, the Star of Oblivion was to be stopped. That is my role, and my purpose. At last, that time has come. Now there is no need for the Blue Moon. Moon! You have fulfilled your purpose. Return to the dust that bore you. Alexandra, this is what you meant, isn't it?
Congratulations, Cyrus. You were magnificent.
Alexandra. Thank you. You opened my eyes. Always been waiting for this moment. Time to say farewell. Goodbye, my friends.
So, beneath it all, Cyrus was just a nice little boy with a huge responsibility. So big, he almost couldn't handle it. But now he's finally going to a place he can call home.
Yeah, thanks to Cyrus, the world can go on without being destroyed ever again. The ruler of darkness, Emperor Griffin. There never really was such a person. He was just a mass illusion created by the evil in men's hearts.
Wow, that's pretty deep, Max. Kind of poetic, really.
Well, you know.
Dork.
We've sure been through a lot, but I guess it's over. There's only one moon in the sky now.
Yeah, and so it begins. A new era bathed in the light of a single moon.
Ugh, that's laying it on a bit thick.
But will people ever believe there was once two moons?
They might. People can lock their special memories in their hearts. But at some point, they just forget to take them out again. This incredible adventure that we all shared, one day, it may too end up being forgotten. The people in the future will likely forget many things. The fact that I was here, and also that long ago, two moons shined down from the starry sky.
It's time for us to say goodbye too, hey, Max? It was fun traveling with you. I won't ever forget you. And Max, you'd better not forget me either.
Don't worry. I won't forget you, Monica. Or my journey, or how we fought together. I could never forget any of that.
Well, good then.
I consider it a true honor to have met you, Max.
That goes for me as well.
Max, you were wonderful. I'm so proud of you.
Mother.
It's time to say goodbye, Max. Be strong, my son.
I will. And I'm not going to cry. I've seen lots of tears shed lately, and it's made me a stronger person.
Max, there was so much I wanted to tell you. And there was so much I wanted to hear about you. I'm so sorry.
I know. I'll write you a letter, Mother. I'll put in it everything that happened on our adventure. Then I'll hide the letter right here, so that it'll reach you even in the future. Mother?
Yes. I look forward to that.
Mother, I'm so happy that I was able to meet you.
Always be good to yourself, Max. Goodbye, my heart.
Mother!
The Chrono Union is closing. This journey was like some kind of dream. Castles floating in the air, moons becoming one.
Yeah, just like a dream.
You're right. Your journey was just a dream.
Huh?
There's always been just one moon. All this may just have been a long, long dream shown to us humans by the ancients to warn us.
A dream, huh? Yeah, right.
Well, Mother, it turned out a little long, but this is finally the end of my letter. We really had an amazing adventure. But it was a lot of fun, too. After all, I managed to meet you and Monica. Finally, this is our true goodbye. Please, Mother, don't forget about me. Take care. I'll be here in my time, doing fine. Farewell to my future mother.
I'd like to thank you all for watching this series to the end. It's been fun sharing this. Sorry, the ending always chokes me up a little. It's been a pleasure to share one of my favorite games of all time with a YouTube audience. I hope you've enjoyed watching me play this game. I hope if you've not played this game yourself, this has inspired you to pick it up and give it a try for yourself. There's so much in this game to enjoy, and it's so much fun to play over and over again.
It's a dream, it's a hope that one day we'll be free. Give me strength to open up the door. Only the strong ones can stand the test of time. Caught in between these two.
I hope you will join me again for my next level 5 RPG Let's Play series, which will be Rogue Galaxy.
When this wonderful world starts to shine, this timeless journey far from home, I gave it all up to make a change.
The door.